The surgical management for movement disorders, we can broadly think of it as encompassing two different varieties, stimulation and lesioning. Stimulation, or deep brain stimulation, involves putting electrodes into the brain, connecting them through wires to a generator placed in the chest. The entire system can almost be thought of as a pacemaker for the brain, just as a pacemaker for the heart can help correct abnormal heartbeat. A pacemaker for the brain, or deep brain stimulation, can help correct abnormal brain rhythms and mitigate symptoms of movement disorders. Lesioning procedures, on the other hand, work by creating a tiny destruction within a very highly selective brain region, thought to be responsible for the movement disorder. Generally speaking, it's done either through radio waves, called radiosurgery, or through sound waves, and called focused ultrasound. Each of the two treatment options carries its own pluses and minuses. Deep brain stimulation, for instance, is very versatile. It can treat symptoms on both body sides, and it carries a very high success rate, but it does involve actual surgery, and so it entails risks of surgery. Lesioning type procedures, on the other hand, for instance, focused ultrasound, are non-invasive. They don't require a cut through the skin, they don't require a hole in the skull, but often, generally speaking, they can only be used for one body side. And so deciding which is the better option, deciding what the best option for patients is multifactorial, patient-specific, and it requires weighing and balance specific symptoms that patients have, as well as the patient's general health, as well as their goals and their preferences. Evaluating patients for movement disorders, surgically speaking, is best done by a functional neurosurgeon. These are surgeons with advanced training in using a combination of brain anatomy, brain mapping techniques, as well as state-of-the-art neurosurgical tools and technology to target very selective brain regions. And typically, functional neurosurgeons perform all different types of stimulation as well as lesioning procedures, and so they're well-versed in weighing in balance different factors simultaneously and guiding patients through the decision-making.